गुड मॉर्निंग मैम, आई हार्टली वेलकम यू ऑन कॉलेज दुनिया प्लेटफॉर्म। सो मैम, शैल वी बिगिन?
यस यस।
ओके, सो मैम, माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, बीइंग द वाइस प्रिंसिपल, हाउ डू यू स्ट्रेटजाइज अबाउट द की प्रोग्राम्स एंड प्लान्स फॉर द मार्केटिंग एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ योर इंस्टीट्यूट?
गुड मॉर्निंग फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टू ऑल ऑफ यू हु आर लिसनिंग। As a vice principal, now there is a demand of time, like everybody is going for digital marketing, e-presence, so all these things are there, but we are more focusing on the quality of product, that is our students. So we are focusing on the quality of academics, and when our product is talking much about our efforts, so we need less marketing. That is what I believe. So we take efforts on quality improvement academically or the overall growth of our students, and their skill enhancement, knowledge enrichment, making them industry ready. So all these aspects we are considering. When our stakeholders, our students, employers, parents, and all the other stakeholders are talking about the quality, we need to take very less efforts on marketing. That is what I feel. And regarding administration, so for smooth admin work, it is only possible with the proper coordination and dedication of office staff. So we are having the well-trained and updated office staff, admin and back office employees. So who are getting time to time training on different technologies and softwares. And in coming days, we are planning to go for 100% paperless. So more efficiency and quality will definitely achieve in coming days. So that's all.
Okay. So ma'am, my next question is, what are the benefits and career options after pursuing the BCA course?
Okay, actually this is the BBA CA, so Business Administration and Computer Application. So after this, lot many opportunities are there for the students. So this is related to application, that is applying the technical knowledge in day-to-day life. So in this course, students will be getting the knowledge about computer technologies, different technologies, then fundamentals of management, accounting, business mathematics, statistics, that means overall, almost all the domains are covered. So even they are having business communication. So all these topics, subjects are there in this curriculum. So they are getting overall all the domain knowledge, and they can, and since this is a computer application, so we teach them or make them habit to apply all this knowledge in respective domains. So even our students are designing some apps in maybe they are getting jobs in gaming, testing, networking, network security, banking. So all sectors are open for these students because they are having overall all the fields covered in this curriculum, and they are getting that domain knowledge also. So BBA CA, that is BCA, previously it is known as. So it is very good curriculum, and last year it is now having the latest technologies. So it is upgraded, having upgraded syllabus also. So all the latest technologies which is a market demand, all are included in the syllabus.
Thank you, ma'am. That was quite good to know. So in MIT ACSE, BCA department is also into research and application development. And we also know that the student has developed applications under your guidance. So tell us something about it.
Yes, yes. Normally, the students, every student is not satisfied with the whatever is going on in a curriculum. They want something extra. So these are the advanced learner category type of students. So they are having brilliant ideas, and they come up with many solutions to many issues. So all these students, we groom them for research and all these activities, application development activities. So normally these students go for and if they are taking it seriously, so they can go for the application development in different aspects. Not only BCA students, all the departments are working on that thing. So many of our students are having their apps on mobile applications on Play Store also. Like they have designed stickers for work. They are having even electronic students have prepared sensor-based tube lights in our own campus. Only digital notice board, then PA system they have developed. They have TV signal analyzer system, TV transmission center. Then environmental parameter display is there. One of our students have developed one application which is very much useful in agriculture sector also. That is checking of moisture, soil quality. So all these things are there. Plus one student who is presently in third year only, he have developed one application on Bhagavad Gita. And it is getting implemented by one of the organizations. So all these things they are doing and very seriously. One of our students have proposed for a startup on complete IT solutions. And that project was have got selected in Savitribai Phule Pune University in incubation center. And he got lakhs of funding for that. So this way they are doing very well at this stage also, in learning phase also. So they have no limits for all these things. And they are doing really well. And we are really proud of our students.
Okay, so ma'am, my next question is that what are the types of projects that the students are working on through this program?
Right now, there is one of the projects which is very challenging. We have language lab in our college. So one of our students is working on the project which is only dedicated for language lab. So he prepared a system in which there is a vocabulary, translation, pronunciation, then different types of tests students can give. So our students can sharpen their reading, writing, English reading, writing, listening, speaking abilities over there. And that is a very good system actually. Software development, software developed by our student only, for our students only. So developed by student for students. So it is a very good project. Then there is one more project on which students are working, like which is again for a green road or green corridor for ambulances. So they have prepared a model on that, which is again selected in hackathon competition also. And they're working on that. That small model is also prepared and they're working on it. So that ambulance can reach to the destination as fast as it's possible. So all these projects are under development and students are really working good. And there are many applications. One scanner application is there, which is on the available on the Play Store, and some improvements are also going on in the that particular application also. And we are also using that scanner for our day-to-day life. So it's a Make in India product, Make in College only. So such projects are under development.
Wow, ma'am, I must say that your students are doing really, really very great. So, ma'am, with the growing need of the students to be industry ready, can you please highlight the facilities provided in your institute?
Yes, yes. Actually, students are having a lot of potential. So, the only thing we need to appreciate them, motivate them, and some of the support like technical or monetary. So, we are providing that through different clubs and cells. So we are having innovation club in our college. So through that, we are promoting the innovative ideas. So students are coming with their innovative ideas, which are being promoted from college side motivated the students are getting motivation for different competitions like hackathon or project competitions, research competitions or entrepreneurship competitions. So all these things we are and they are showcasing their talent very well. We are having R&D cell, research and development cell also, under which different competitions, again like Shodh. Shodh is the research competition, which is intercollegiate competition right now. We are going to take it at state level also. So different workshops are conducted for students, expert lectures for guidance. So all these things are conducted. And we are regularly trying to inculcate the research culture in students. And they are also giving proper and positive response for that. And we used to organize workshops on robotics. And again, after that workshop, immediately we are organizing for last 3 years, we are having this type of workshop. And immediately after that workshop, we used to conduct a competition so that they'll get confidence to compete with other college students also. And outside of college, they are getting exposure. So all these things are being done. Again, we are taking them to different industries for visits so that they'll get the exposure to work culture, actual work culture, how it is going and where they are going after their graduation. So when they'll be getting employed. So all these things we are doing. Next is different festivals, like per department and at college level also, we are organizing different events like IT Fest, which is the Intelligence Fest, then Commerce Week, Science Week is there, then IPSAM, that is Management Week is there, MPulse, that is the MIT Pulse. So we are having those competitions also. So through these competitions, they are grooming themselves, like overall personality development they'll be having, so leadership quality, because students themselves are arranging all the things, organizing the things, coordinating with each other. Only faculties are the for support if they stuck with something, then otherwise students are completely managing the whole activity and very well they are doing in that. Again, they can groom their improve their professional skills, presentation skills, convincing skills. They are bringing up the sponsorships for these events. So all these things they can do, even decision making, they can improve in their decision making, critical thinking. So all these aspects are covered through these competitions and through these participations. And we are continuously behind them that they have to, everyone will participate. So, and they are also responding very positively.
And that is quite good to know that MIT ACSE is, you know, focusing on overall development of a student. So that will be really helpful for all the aspiring students. So, but ma'am, being the vice principal of MIT Art, Commerce and Science College, what is your philosophy of leadership? How would you describe your leadership style?
I'm basically an academician. So last 20 years, I'm almost working. Before this college, I was in training. And since inception of this college, right from 2008, I'm here. So being an academician, I believe in continuous learning. So still, I have developed some, exactly not a philosophy, but I have some principles in my life. So regarding leadership, I believe clarity of vision, that is the base for leadership. And after that, to implement it or to achieve that goal, we have to percolate all these things to the people, each and every person in the organization. So and around us. So then only that vision becomes true. So for moving towards our goal, we need to walk together on a common vision. So the team building is the most important aspect. So I believe in teamwork. So I always try to communicate with people, understand the people, and then I focus on team building. Clear communication is again one of the aspects. So when you are clearly communicating all these things, you are open for a communication. So there won't be any misunderstanding or misconception in to achieve a vision. And your approach must be broad and inclusive. So you have to consider each and every person in your organization. That is what I believe. So inclusion means involving and taking care of each and every person. We have to take the opinion of each and every person, because everyone is again contributing in building a success. So every person is the as important as the leader is. So that is the most important thing. Next thing is the trust in their leader. So how to build that trust? So that is coming through an integrity. So each and every leader have to, I think, take care of integrity of the organization. So trust in any leadership is directly proportionate when the path is with a low risk and responsibility is, there should be a faith that there is somebody behind them to take the responsibility. There is some part of risk only. So risk, naturally, leader has to take the risk, but everyone will be taking the care of responsibility if they are having that trust. Okay. And the leader, you must be open to listen, accept and adapt. So you should have that flexibility that any person is coming to you trying to say something, then you should be open to listen those opinions. If you feel it is correct, you have to accept it, appreciate it. So all these things should be there. And leader must be optimistic, first of all. Then the whole organization will become optimistic. So this is the most important thing. So we have to be adaptable, then ready to adjust with circumstances. Right now we are going through the difficult conditions, but still we have not stopped anything. Everything is going on properly, like a routine. So you have to be adaptable and flexible to the situations. So you have to learn out something out of experience and circumstances which are coming towards you. So all these things should be there in leader. And I believe these things, you cannot just tell the people. When you are following all these qualities, people will automatically, because everyone is watching you, so people will automatically go on the same path. You need not tell them and make it compulsory. It will automatically happen because your act itself speaks rather than your words. That is what I believe. So I first walk on that path, so everybody automatically walks. So that is the way of leadership or style of leadership.
I must say, ma'am, that was really very insightful. So, ma'am, how do you see as MIT ACSE's biggest trends?
Okay. We are having, because we are affiliated college to the Pune University. So everybody has given a specific curriculum and every college needs to follow that. But apart from that, what we are giving extra, that is our strength. So we have included all these things in our regular curriculum, like add-on courses are included, then elective subjects are there. I think just a minute, ma'am. There is, regarding strengths of the MIT ACSE, we are having strong academics. And there is no compromise in quality of education. It is well disciplined because whenever students are coming out from junior colleges or schools, they feel like this is a college and we need not bother about anything. But that is not the thing, because these are the 3 years which are very much crucial. So we have to take care of discipline also. That is not like a strict nice, there is a difference, but this, you have to be self-disciplined, and we teach them to be self-disciplined, well-cultured, well-behaved human being. Then value-based education should be there in colleges, so we are implementing that also, and we look after their career as well as their overall personality grooming, just like their parents. So they may feel like this is like a school only. Many times we get that feedback also, but they have to complete their assignments and all on time. So all these things we follow, and ultimately after 3 years we are getting feedback from those students only that you are doing these things, that is why we are at this level. So thank you for that. So when we are listening that feedback, that is a good thing. But at the start, they may feel like in college also we have to follow this discipline. So these things happens, but that is actually the strength of MIT SASC. That is what I feel.
Okay, so ma'am, we would like to know about the curriculum of BCA. Like, how does it ensure the best practice of the industry that is relevant in the real world?
Actually, this course is introduced by the university as a professional course. So, and as I said, only in last year only, they have updated that syllabus completely. So, they are having all the domain knowledges. They are having all the subjects, at least fundamentals, students have to make it clear. And they have added some add-on courses from university side. But we are giving extra, apart from add-on courses, there are some courses which are required in market. And every year market demand changes. So we used to change the add-on courses also and the value addition courses also. So every year we are providing a new curriculum apart from the regular curriculum of the university. Even we are conducting foreign language courses also, certifications also in our college, which is supporting to this curriculum. And in curriculum, they have included elective subjects. So they have given electives from second year onwards and compulsory projects for every semester from second year. So that is the good thing. And project-based learning is the best learning. That is what I feel. And in credit system, we can even offer students some internships or certifications from some authorized, reputed organizations like Microsoft certifications or Google certifications. So we are motivating students for these certifications. Even IITs are conducting NPTEL online programs, MOOC. So every student is going for, because we are the local chapter for that NPTEL courses. So every student is motivated for these certifications. And we are giving extra credits for all these certifications and internships to the students. So they are getting motivated for all these things. And they are getting hands-on trainings, even through internships. And our training and placement department is continuously working on internships also. They are taking same efforts as your placements on internships also. So that is the market requirement right now. And in BCA and all the courses, we are following it.
Okay, ma'am. So what would you like students to know about MIT ACSC that they might not know already?
Yes, yes. In MIT ACSC, as I said, quality education is there. That is, academics will be properly followed. We are having separate training and placement department. So normally, arts, commerce, science colleges does not have separate dedicated staff for training and placement, but we are having a separate department with proper resource persons are there, and they are taking continuous efforts on internships, placements, and their grooming, training, everything. And right from first year only, we are grooming them for placements like aptitude, communication, Then there are regular technical interviews, mock interviews, industry visits, all these they are taking care of. Then we are having entrepreneurship development cell. In under this, if student doesn't want to go for placement, they can go for or opt for entrepreneurship. So this cell is continuously working on their skills for entrepreneurship. They are collecting their ideas, sending them for different competition. So all these things are being done. Apart from that, as I said, this is a very safe and secure campus for all the students. And we are we believe like every student should feel comfortable and secure within this campus. And for that, we are having separate cells, grievance cells, anti-ragging cells, students' grievance cells. So all these are there. They are continuously taking efforts to prevent all these grievances, first of all. And if anything, if student feels like anything, I don't feel comfortable, they are ready to, or they should feel free to talk to the concerned person. They are available 24/7 for students. Even we have made one scheme, like a student counseling scheme. Under that, we are having batches of 20 students. And per batch, we are having one faculty mentor who is taking care of those 20 students. Taking care means academics, if they are having any issues, they are having any personal issues, if they feel like they are not having or comfortable in any of the hostels, so they can even talk about their personal issues. So anything, any issue they are having, they can freely talk to that mentor. All the heads of the departments, principals, vice principals, everyone is approachable and accessible for students at any moment and any time. So we are, even in pandemic, we are continuously with students. I'll not say we are there for students. We are with students every time. Students are sending us messages, calling us, and they are getting their problems resolved. So that is the bonding between the college, you can say the faculties and students. And that is the most important thing, what is what I feel.
Of course, ma'am, this is really a good initiative. Ma'am, lastly, I would like to know that do you have any suggestions to give to the current youth and the aspiring students?
Yes. Students, every student, as we know, student means who is ready to learn. So they have to be always a student. That will be my suggestion, because in this era, everybody have keep alive, like, every faculty is continuously learning, so students should also keep that ability in them forever their life. So learning ability should be there. Students should have some ambition, because without ambition they cannot work. Or if they don't have any goal, they will not go in a right direction, because there are many distractions, and if you are not focused on your goal, you cannot achieve it. They have to seriously think about their creativity, because right now we are having all the gadgets in our hand, and we are somewhere it is harmful for a creativity, because we are not even thinking for a second, and we are putting the things on Google and search for it. So creativity must be there in students. Then the most important thing right now, intelligence is the most important thing, but again, apart from that, emotional quotient, emotional intelligence should also be there in the students. That is, again, moral values should be there. Otherwise, what we are listening around us. So if we are properly inculcating these values in students, so they will take it from our institution, and they will keep all these values with them. So that will be very good thing. And most importantly, they have to be a good human being. So I strongly believe that when you are giving your best, then definitely best will come to you. So everybody need to try for this. Whenever you are having all the technical knowledge, again the question arises of application. So just for exam point of view, you should not study. You have to apply that knowledge for social responsibilities. You have to understand the social issues and apply your knowledge, any field, not only computer applications, but if you are studying in any field, try to apply that knowledge for social commitment. And don't work for your personal growth only, because everybody earns money at some level of in your life. But don't think about only for a personal growth. Apply your knowledge for the betterment of society, and ultimately you are the part of society. So that whatever you are doing for society, that will automatically come to you. So you have to think about that also very seriously. So that is the message from my side to the students.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am. It was really such an enriching experience interacting with you. Thank you so much for your time as well.
Thank you so much. Thank you for organizing such a nice conversation.
Yeah.